Thanks to Thorum for sponsoring today's video. Imagine seeing a glowing light suspended in the air. It looks almost like a duplicate sun, blindingly bright and fixed at some point low on the horizon. Suddenly, the clouds pass overhead and the dazzling light vanishes like vapor. No, this isn't a scene from a fantasy movie, but an optical occurrence called a subsun, which is one of several uncommon kinds of ice halos. If you watched my previous video on ice halos, then you already know a few of the better known types. A quick recap, halos are optical phenomena that appear when light hits tiny ice crystals that are suspended in the atmosphere. Scientists have identified 119 kinds so far, and there may be others we don't know about. Today, we'll look at a few of the rarer and most unusual kinds of ice halos. As you'll see, these phenomena can be very strange, and the best way to understand them is as optical illusions that don't truly exist in space. Nonetheless, if you happen to be in the right place at the right time, you'll be treated to some of the dazzling sights that test the boundaries of what is real and what is an illusion. I'm Alex McColgan, and you're watching Astrum. Join me today as we look at stunning high-definition images of some of the rarest and most unusual ice halos, including subsuns, Bötlinger's rings, light pillars, and more. Let's start with a little primer. Ice halos are produced by water crystals that are usually found in cirrus or cirrostratus clouds. Cirriform clouds occur high in the troposphere, usually 5 to 10 kilometers above the Earth's surface, where temperatures are very cold. These ice crystals are very small, usually less than 10 micrometers long, and always have uniform interfacial angles. So uniform, in fact, that the angles between any two faces in an ice crystal are completely identical. However, despite this angular regularity, ice crystals vary in size and shape. Some crystals are flat, like hexagonal plates, whereas others form as columns with a hexagonal cross-section. The subsun we looked at earlier requires plate-shaped crystals to occur. As the plate crystals settle downward, atmospheric drag orients them parallel to the Earth's surface, much like how sun dogs occur. Subsuns form when disturbances in the air introduce a wobble to these plate-shaped crystals. The more wobble the plates have, the more vertically elongated the subsun will appear. Occasionally, there is so much vertical elongation that the plates produce a categorically distinct type of halo known as a sun pillar. These only appear when the sun is between 20 degrees and 6 degrees above the horizon. However, while sun pillars might look like beams of light shooting from the ground, this effect is deceiving. What's really happening is that the plate crystals act like millions of tiny mirrors, which bounce the light rays towards the observer along a vertical axis. These scattered rays then produce a diffuse reflection visible to an observer as a pillar of light. A similar effect happens when the sun sets over water, bouncing a diffuse reflection off the water surface that sometimes looks like an elongated pillar. What do you think? Can you see a resemblance? Sometimes light pillars can appear when the moon is the primary light source. As you might have guessed, these are known as moon pillars. This image shows a beautiful one captured by the European Space Agency over Antarctica. However, when the conditions are right, light pillars can come from all kinds of sources, even artificial ones. On occasion, this has led to some dramatic scenes. In this photo, low-forming ice crystals called diamond dust have settled close to the Earth's surface, creating a spectacle that looks almost like an alien arrival. And if you haven't heard about the peculiar effects of tiny ice crystals suspended in the Earth's atmosphere, you can hardly be blamed for jumping to conclusions. I wonder how many eyewitness accounts of mysterious lights can be explained by halos like this one. Let's look at a different, but equally strange phenomenon called Bötlinger's rings. First documented during a hot air balloon flight in 1909, Botlinga's rings usually last for only a few seconds, although occasionally they can be visible for upwards of an hour. They typically appear as shimmering elliptical rings around the sun, but due to the sun's intense glare, they are more likely to be sighted around dimmer subsuns. Most sightings of them tend to occur in airplanes. Botlinga's rings were originally thought to be produced by plate crystals that had developed a gyrational motion. However, simulations have recently shown that the effect can be more effectively reproduced by pyramidal-shaped crystals, with a small amount of wobble. Still, there's a lot we don't know about Botlinga's rings, and the current theories are mostly educated guesswork. The pyramidal crystals that work in simulations have very wide apex angles, such that they take on a flat, almost plate-like appearance. The problem is that these shapes are unlikely to form naturally from ice's molecular lattice structure. All we really know is that these elusive halos are extremely rare. Lastly, I'll leave you with a rare cousin of the circular halo called superlateral arcs. Unlike 22 degree halos, superlateral arcs never form from a complete circle, although they sometimes form at the same time as circular halos, producing a complex halo effect. Superlateral arcs appear as colored bands above the sun, but never reach below it. When their colors are visible, red is the closest band to the sun, with blue on the outer edge. We think superlateral arcs form because of hexagonal rods or column-shaped crystals when light enters the base and refracts through the prism side. While these arcs are sometimes confused with 46-degree halos, which are a larger cousin of the 22-degree circular halo, they are a separate phenomenon that visually resembles rainbows due to their arc shape and sometimes colorful appearance. So, there we have it. A journey through the dazzling and illusory world of rare and unusual ice halos. As I mentioned earlier, halos are still a growing area of research, and there may be other kinds of even rarer halos that have yet to be documented. So, if you've ever seen anything strange and hard to explain, I'd love to hear it. It's possible you've seen something that scientists don't know about yet. And have you seen any of these rarer types of ice halos? I'd love to hear it in the comments. If you do have images to share, please tag me on Facebook or Instagram here. Rings around the sun can be rare and eye-catching, but they don't last very long. Wouldn't you like something a little more permanent? But not just an ordinary ring. What about one handcrafted using meteorite or dinosaur bone? You might not think that such a ring could be real, but the sponsor of today's video, Thorum, would like to disagree. Thorum makes rings for weddings, anniversaries, or just general wear, using all sorts of unique materials like Damascus steel, World War II rifle stocks, and countless other options. I love my ring with a band of real meteorite fragments running all the way around it, as it feels like I'm carrying a little bit of space around with me, perfect for my interests. Every purchase comes with a 1-year, no questions asked warranty, a beautiful wooden ring box, and a silicon activity band. And if you use our promo code ASTRUM, you can get 20% off. Head on over to thorum.com by clicking the link in the description below to check it out. I highly recommend it. Thanks for watching. If you missed the first Ice Halos video, be sure to check it out here. If you like what I'm doing and want to support the channel, plus have your name added to this list, please consider becoming a patron or a member using the links below. All the best, and see you next time.